between us. And now I'm going outside. We'll be a real family.
Geez, what a nice lady to do that, eh?
Yes, sure is.
These are pricey, aren't they?
I'll say. Perhaps we'd better have another look at those tops in the bargain basin.
Yeah. What about this one? This is only $20.99.
Oh, the colour suits you just perfectly, dear, but I do think just a couple of sizes smaller.
Yes, well,
it's
actually,
not it's really for my friend. We're looking for something for an aunt of mine.
Oh, I see. Well, in that case, you've made the perfect choice. It's a lovely knit and wonderfully flattering to the matronly figure.
We'll just see what else you've got.
Yes, of course. Take your time.
Of course, if Etty doesn't like it, I can always buy it from her.
Did you notice that chap behind me in the other shop? Actually, I think I did.
Probably just a coincidence.
Hi. Name's Jim Bent. Been following you since you left Wentworth. Reporter. Is it true Miss Etty Parslow has spent the last 45 years in the pen for something she didn't do?
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
I can't or won't.
Goodbye, Mr. Bent. And don't try following us anymore. I'll be forced to call the police.
What's the matter with you today? You've hardly potted any at all.
Sorry, Lex, just not concentrating, I guess.
Doesn't worry me. $2 coming up. Move over, Eddie Charlton. G'day.
Hi, Mal.
Well, can we have a talk?
Yeah, sure. Why? Oh, you won anyway.
Hey, just don't forget the dough, lover boy.
Yeah.
Cheers.
What is the matter with Marlene?
Well, nothing important, I hope.
Hey. Reckon she'll lay off you now?
Only if I come up with something to keep her permanently in her place.
You'd have to do it.
Yeah, probably the only thing that'll work. I want to come up with something a little less drastic.
Like what?
Getting rid of her muscle men. She hasn't got the guts to try anything on her own.
Yeah, it should work. What if she teams up with Burke again? You can't keep him in isolation forever.
No, I think she's gone off Burke since he screwed up her drug racket.
Better safe than sorry. You look out for Kelly's mates and I'll take care of Burke.
You're on. Yes, lady. You've got good reason to look worried.
Sorry, Marla. Well, I just don't know what you're getting at.
Well, how about telling me why you're in there? I mean, we never talk about it. And I don't think we should keep secrets, do you?
Not real proud about what I did.
Yeah, well, I'm not either. But at least I told you what it was.
Yeah, well. Oh, jeez, Ma, I bashed this guy. It's me mate, too. Something got in the way.
Is it true he was gay?
Who told you that?
It doesn't matter. Is it true?
Yeah. Oh, I'm not proud of what I done, Ma. It won't happen again, honest.
How do you know it won't?
Well, I can't be sure, but... Oh, I reckon it only happened now because I didn't have someone I could talk to. You know, just get things off my chest. Well, anyway, got you now, Marl. Marl? Marl! Marl!
Ah, quite you trying to skip battle, eh?
Oh, that, love. I got plenty of money. Did you hear my good news?
Yeah, it's terrific, Eddie. Good on you. Yeah.
Is Marlene okay?
Oh, yeah, she just forgot something, that was
oh,
all.
Oh, yeah, I have too.
Hey, hang on a minute. Got me some money.
What was it, $2 or something? There you go.
Hey, Chuck, come on, have another game. Help me build up my bank.
Well, I'd love to, Lex.
No, come on, no arguments.
I said I'd meet Ma.
Marlene?
I feel such a fool. You didn't tell anyone, did you? About what we were talking about?
Of course not, love. What did Matt say?
He admitted it.
What, he came straight out and said he was gay?
He
didn't have to. You just said it would never have happened if you hadn't been so lonely.
Oh, come on, love. Being lonely doesn't make you a homosexual. Matt's still the same terrific guy he always
He's
was.
He's not. I can't, Jude. I just can't marry someone who's queer.
Marlene.
Do you need company?
No. What's the problem? I'm sorry, Mara. She told me something in confidence I'd rather not say. Mara? Look, I'm sure once she's thought it through, she'll want to tell you about it.
Oh, I wasn't thinking of that. No, I've got my own problems. You're copying it from all sides tonight.
Oh, what's wrong?
Kelly, I figure the only way to put a spanner in her works is to talk her heavies into not working for her.
Well, that'll take some talking.
Well, if I have to use heavy persuasion, I will. But I need someone to keep knit.
How about now?
Now. What do you want? Just a little bit of cooperation, Deacon. I'll get it too. One way or another.
Don't know.
Hey, Rabbit, where's the Yorkshire put anyhow? He led us out ages ago.
How else should I know?
You never get a stinking show at this rate. Hey, what happened to your face?
None of your business. Pretend I'm not here, okay?
Hey, Fran, where's Kath?
How the hell would I know?
Hey, Deacon, you're wanted.
Hey, Kath, wait a minute.
What the hell happened to you? What's going on here anyway? Fran's marked up too.
Ask Fran.
What? You walk away from me, Deacon, or your other eye will match. Just rack off. You're buggered if I'm going to cop a bashing every time I talk to you.
How's the gut ache, Kelly?
You bitch, it was you, wasn't it? Lost your ring of confidence? Very funny. You might have scared off those two wards, but you'll laugh on the other side of your face when Alice gets out.
I wouldn't count on it. She's wearing a murder wrap for you, remember?
Hey! It's here, everybody! My big day!
Yeah. Come on, you've got to have a bubble bath to
celebrate. Sorry, ladies. Letty lost her towel.
Oh, I'd like the story.
These hairs are getting wet now.
Of course you could, love. Don't take any notice.
Go on, through you go. Well,
through you go.
Hey, Dick. What happened to that eye?
Had a bad dream, Mr. Sick. Must have bumped it on the bend.
Walking.
Looks like it.
Yeah.
Oh, hi. How did the shopping go?
Good. We're much better bargain hunters than we thought. Oh, and what do you think of this? How about that for the entrance and the living areas? And that for the bedrooms?
Oh, nice. We better get a shift on, though, if we're going to get it done before you move in.
Dennis, I can't expect you to give up all your free time. No, I'm going to organise for somebody to come in and do it tomorrow.
Well, you made her money. Look, I don't mind a bit. I've nothing else to do, and I enjoy doing it.
Oh. All right. Well, actually, I quite enjoy doing it myself, but we are running out of time. I'll have the tenants knocking on the door before I'm ready to move in.
Well, the two of us slapping paint on, we'll get it done in no time.
Right. Is tonight too soon?
Oh, well, I did have this date lined up.
Oh,